right! Monday.
Dude, it's totally Monday.
All right, so I made it. I made it 72 hours.
Woo!
Pump it up.
I made it. Can you believe it? March 4th, baby. I survived. I survived the 72-hour fast. I honestly can't believe I made it. That bitter bean juice tastes so good in the mornings. Last night at midnight was when the 72-hour fast ended, so I ended up going to Mega. Why Mega, you might ask? Who's really wanting to go to Mega after a 72-hour fast? That was the place that was open, so that's where I ended up going, because I was hungry, okay?
Breakfast just sounded delicious, and it's what was open at the time, so that's what I had.
I got myself a Western omelet and a big old side of bacon. No toast. It was absolutely delicious. It gave me the poops last night. I did it. I can't believe I did it. I mean, I can believe I did it. The power of you put your mind to anything, right? I am proud of myself for doing it. I'll pat myself on the back. I know. I can't believe it either. But the truth is the 72-hour fast was extremely challenging. It was hard. I wanted to eat my stomach sometimes. My stomach wanted to eat my stomach several times. I felt that might have been actually happening. A couple of the tricks were every time I got hungry, I just chugged some water. Sleeping, you know, you're not hungry when you're asleep. So going to bed early, sleeping in the morning. That's why I did it over the weekend. Sure, it wasn't the most ideal time to end at midnight, but the mental state that it put me in and the can-do attitude and made me realize that, you know what, I do have control over my life. Like, in the sense that I should already know this, but 3 days without food, like, it takes some willpower and discipline, man. There were so many times I was ready to cave. Just didn't do it. Like, I was like, ah. Saturday was like so hard. It was brutal. I'm like, I want to eat some food, but everyone else is eating food and they're eating it in front of me, right in my face. And they're like, go ahead, man, just have one. You're good. And I'm like, no, can't do it. And then after I hit the halfway point, like after I hit 48 hours and I only had one day left, it just became a lot easier. It was like, dude, you've got one day left. Everything's downhill. It is literally a countdown at this moment. Like, the last 24 hours made it a lot easier. And not to say that the last 24 hours was easy by any means, because I was so hungry the whole time. Mild headache the whole time. Just kept drinking the water. I'm like, I know I can survive this. I'm not gonna die. So many people have survived 3 days without food. I'm sure that I could survive 3 days without food. And I did. And the first day, hell, I thought I wasn't going to make it. I really thought that this isn't going to work. This isn't going to work too well. Mind power. Put your mind to it. You can do anything. So now I got to stay strict with the rest of my challenge, which no fast food, no pop, no beer, no bread or pasta. No porn. I don't know why I added that on the list. No porn. Who does that? I don't even know why I added that on the list. I just figured, well, that could be a challenge. That might be hard. I tell you what, I missed my coffee probably the most. I really do miss my Joe. Back in the studio with Damon McKenzie this week at Fire Hyena Studios in Saginaw. Working on this track that I'm super stoked about. Getting that accomplished. Going through mounds and mounds and mounds of data. All the files I gotta get around. I wanna post some things for sale today, but I've been researching where I'm gonna post everything. That's been like the other thing. It's like all these fees of, oh hey, you're gonna sell it here, but it's gonna cost you this much to sell it. Or like, oh, are you gonna use Facebook Marketplace? And then I heard of this new thing called Let Go. It sounded pretty interesting, and I've talked to some people that have had pretty good luck with that. But I've got to do some research and actually find out what's going to work best for me. Why haven't I done this research already?
It's a good question, Dan. Why haven't you done any of this already?
I haven't done any of this because I've been taking photos of the stuff I have, trying to catalog what I have, so that I could put that together on wherever I'm posting it. Now it's time to figure out where it's going. Blah. I don't know where I'm going to post it yet. But on Wednesday when I update you again, I'll definitely let you know where it ended up getting posted. Because that's the new thing. I have to get stuff out. I'm tired of sitting on it. I've been too lazy. I haven't really been that lazy, but I've been able to do more. That's the thing, isn't it? When you're doing a million things, things get like knocked off the list and you're always stacking more things on the list. Every day, you're like, oh, I scratched off three things, but I added five. I never know when I'm ahead. No one likes long lists. I'd be done watching me too. Are you still watching? Are you who watches the endings? Now you're watching this ending and it's all weird. Seriously, though, hope everyone has an amazing Monday, has an amazing week. I'll see you again Wednesday. Keep the dirty side down and the shiny side up.